Hi everybody, this is Lars Vemje for Nukepedia, and welcome to volume 15 of our video series, Useful Nukepedia Tools. Today's video is about stamps version 1.0 by Adrian Pueyo and Alexey Kuchinski. Stamps is a production-ready node connection system for Nuke. This is the link where you can find it on Nukepedia. It doesn't happen often that tools for Nuke change the way we work as compositors. In my eyes, the W Hotbox by Walter Gilsing and Dust Grain by Fabian Holtz became such game-changing tools for Nuke. Since it's extremely important to keep your node tree clean and organized, stamps is the perfect tool for that task. And I believe it changes the game of connecting nodes in Nuke, which, as we all know, is a pretty substantial part of what we do as Nuke compositors. I will only give you a quick overview of stamps, because Adrian already created 6 awesome in-depth videos in which he explains how stamps works. The main idea behind stamps is to use reference nodes or stamps instead of scattering or even duplicating your source nodes all over your script. That way, you can have all of your sources, like your read nodes, roto nodes, or cameras, in one place and reference them to any other location in your script. Of course, this is not a new concept, but the feature that makes stamps very unique and extremely useful is its tagging system. Let me show you how it works. You can look at stamps like a postage stamp system on steroids that allows you to categorize your source nodes with custom tags or backdrop nodes. So instead of referencing to your source files with a postage stamp or a dot node, you can select them, press your custom shortcut for stamps, give your stamps a name and a custom tag name, which allows you to categorize your source files. We have just created 2 anchors and 2 stamps. The anchors should always be directly connected to the input you want to create a reference for, and the stamps are the references of their respective anchors. To customize the stamps shortcut, you just need to open the stamps config.py file with a text editor and change it to whatever you want in between the parentheses where it says stamps shortcut. Now, if we press our stamps shortcut again, we get a menu in which all of our anchors are categorized by tags, backdrops, all, and popular. You can also find your anchors by their titles. I personally prefer to only work with tags and deactivate the backdrops category. To get rid of the backdrops category in the anchor list, you just have to uncheck the bookmark checkbox in your backdrop nodes. And now, no matter where you are in your script, you can always press the stamps shortcut, select your anchor, and press OK to create a new reference to your source files. You can even copy and paste your stamps without having them lose the connection to their anchors. I could go on and on about stamps, but if you want to know more about this tool, just check out the in-depth videos that Adrian made. Alright, that's it for this episode of Useful Nukepedia Tools. If you have any tool suggestions, just send an email to admin@nukepedia.com. Again, this is Lars Vemje. Thanks for watching, and goodbye everybody.